Don't make me laugh, okay? My name is Maha Farhat. I'm an assistant professor of biomedical informatics at Harvard Medical School and a practicing pulmonary and critical care doctor at Mass General Hospital. And I'm interested in personalizing treatment of patients with infectious disease.
My name is Michael Baym. I'm an assistant professor of biomedical informatics at Harvard Medical School and a mathematician and evolutionary biologist. And I'm interested in how bacteria evolve antibiotic resistance.
From my perspective, drug resistance is a considerable threat to the way we currently practice modern medicine because of the considerable delays that in diagnosing patients with drug resistance that we're currently facing. Often, by the time a patient's recognized to have a drug-resistant infection, they might have suffered considerable disability. And even when it's recognized, often the therapies that we can offer those patients are more limited.
I think from a historical perspective, one of the biggest challenges that we face in antibiotic resistance is just that every time we develop a new antibiotic, resistance very, very rapidly follows. And I think without a real understanding of this process, of how it evolves, we're doomed to repeat our past failures.
Currently, there are essentially tools that allow us to do whole genome sequencing, or essentially sequence the DNA. And by getting the DNA information, we can not only identify whether or not a certain bacteria is present, but also identify the DNA signatures of drug resistance.
I'm really excited to work with Maha because she brings a real perspective of how this affects patients, of how this actually affects how doctors practice. You know, I see bacteria evolve in the lab, but the point ultimately isn't to stay in the lab, it's really to help patients and the practicality of it, and particularly Maha's skills joining medicine and computer science to really say how does the information that we can gather out of these sequences affect medical practice? You know, that's an entire perspective on it that's invaluable.
You know, Michael really brings a unique perspective to the table that I think will be quite valuable for a collaboration that helps us take these technologies and bring them closer to the bedside. So these technologies allow us to do DNA sequencing, but we are at a point where we need to do a lot of experiments in the lab to optimize the way we take patient samples and generate the DNA sequence from it, and also be able to process the information such that we can produce essentially clinically interpretable, clinically actionable data.
But what's exciting to me is that coming from these different backgrounds, from completely different starting points, we ended up converging on a very similar approach to the same problem. And that's exciting.
Yeah, absolutely.